Wasabi! It's Tommy Friggin' Mars here. I'm back. New Harry Styles video with an old video. It was just brought to my attention that I completely stepped right over the falling video. What was happening at that time was I went to Eroda, I watched Adore You, and then the golden video came out and that whole thing happened, exploded, and I totally missed falling. And I was like, yes, that is correct. I have not done falling. I'm going to do it today. Here's the thing. I feel like there's so much going on in the world of Harry Styles. Actually, you know what's weird at this time? Usually in an album cycle, when you're, I don't know, almost a year into a cycle, like the press stuff, it just kind of dies down. I mean, you're releasing singles, but so you get that pop for, you know, a couple weeks or whatever. But with our boy Harold, I love that he's staying pretty much at the forefront, right in front of all of our faces all the time. It's awesome. I'm so happy about that. If it was Watermelon Sugar going number one, the lead up to Golden being released as a single, then the music video, and then there was the Vogue cover. Oh, then he did Cherry performance acoustically. Then he just dropped the behind the scenes video of Golden, which ruled. Coincidentally, I got a lot of messages for you guys that are not with me on Patreon saying, hey, are you going to do that? I did a video over there. I guess I could edit it down and get it out on YouTube here. If you want to see that, if you're interested in that, let me know. But I love that there's so much going on. And then in our little world, the little world that you and I have going together, we have the Harry Styles cover song Cage Match. Cage Match. We have that going on. Actually, let's get into this. Let's do this. Let me pull up the Cage Match real quick because round two just ended last night. Round two ended. That voting happened. And now we are down to the final friggin' four. Final four. And before I give you the pairings, I am not going to lie to you. One of the pairings I feel like should be the final. I feel like it should be the final, personally. Sledgehammer versus Girl Crush. It's not even fair. Absolutely, 100%. It's not even close. That's the toughest matchup of this cage match so far. Cage match. And the other matchup is Ultralight Beam, which beat out Juice. I find that one shocking. The biggest shock of this whole thing so far was both versions of the chain getting knocked out. That was the biggest shock for me. I thought the Live Lounge was going to make it. It did not. The second biggest shocking thing of this whole tournament so far has been that Ultralight Beam knocked out Juice. Did not see that coming. I thought Juice was going to walk away easily. I really did. It's not even saying because I prefer it more. I just felt like it would, you know? It didn't. So now it's You're Still the One versus Ultralight Beam. So Sledgehammer, Girl Crush, Ultralight Beam, You're Still the One, and the winner of those matches will then move on to the final. So I guess this is semifinal, right? Final four, semifinal. We'll move on to the final. Who will it be? You guys get to decide. I'll put that down in the comments below. If you want to hit that link and go vote, let your voice be heard. We're going to find out which is the favorite Harry Styles cover song. Okay, so when I upload these videos, I always try to upload it. If there's a video version, like an actual visual part of it, I always try to upload in these videos. If it gets... there's nothing I can do about it. So if it's not in the video, that's why. I don't know why it happens to some and why it happens not to others or whatever. I have no idea. Some of the videos get through, some of them don't. I don't know if there's an exact science to it. I'm just a squirrel just like everybody else, right? But obviously, if you join me over on the Big P, I upload everything. It has the video and everything for your viewing pleasure. Another thing I'm going to be doing very, very soon on this channel and also over there where I'll be doing the carpool karaoke. So that's coming very soon. I'm also going to dive into those Sirius XM sessions. So that's going to be coming soon. So actually, I got a lot of hairy stuff to go through. Honestly, I got a lot of stuff still to get through, to watch, to share along with you guys. So I was sad like a month ago thinking, wow, this is over. I mean, Harry's over. It's not over. It ain't over. Ain't nothing over. We got a long way to go. All right, let's get into the video. This is Harry Styles Falling official vidja. Looks like he just came out of a pool. Whoa, he is soaked. And it was like water dripping from something. I don't know. Was that a sink or something? Or
I'm in my bed. And you're not here. There's no one to blame but the drink and my wandering hands.
Does anybody know what that drink is? I'm not a huge drinker, so I'm not sure. Whiskey, probably.
It's not what I meant.
Oh, that's a great shot right there with the sun coming in. You can see those sunbursts.
Take it back. I can't unpack the baggage left. What am I now?
Okay, so that was water dripping from the piano at the beginning. Okay. This vocal. Falling. What if I'm down? What if I'm out? What if I'm someone you want? It's a great framing of the shot. He's not dead center, he's just off to the right. It's so cinematic. What a great shot. And then you get to see that huge dimple. It's a great shot, man. I like what he's wearing there, his shirt. It's just kind of like, it's like hanging off him and stuff. It's cool. It's like my favorite part of the song here. That's such an emotional part right there. Gosh! I love that line so much. Oh, it just gave me goosebumps. Golly. What a great song. Okay, so this room's filling up. Oh, that's a cool shot underwater. Oh. I get the feeling that you never need me again. That was a great shot when the water went over his head. Oh, man. This is a great video. Deep right at the end there where he was kind of whimpering or something. Whoa. Okay, that was really good. You know what? I mentioned Adore You at the beginning of this video. That had the same look, that same kind of color, feel, everything about it. I'm wondering if it was the same team that shot that video, because sometimes artists will do that. You know, they'll kind of shoot a run of videos with the same team, like a director or like camera crew, same kind of thing. To me, that looked very much that. It didn't look like that video. What I'm trying to say is it has that look, that feel. This video has the feel of that, like movie-ish. I don't even know what I'm trying to say. Do you guys know what I'm driving at? Anyway, okay, so that was really good. I wanted to say I was thinking something, but I didn't want to speak because that was so deep right there. Deep in the water. That was so deep, though, when he was going underwater. Man, I just felt like suffocating. That was drowning it. That was really cool. So what I was thinking there was, I like how he was singing with so much force, but he wasn't pushing, obviously, because bubbles weren't flying out of his mouth. The oxygen wasn't flying out of him and seeing that in there. And I think that would have been really distracting had he done that. I almost thought to myself was, I wonder if they tried a shot with him pushing out, singing it, or the bubbles or whatever were too distracting. I love how that came out. And then there was just a couple little subtle ones that escaped. If it was through the crack of his mouth or maybe through his nostril, it just made for a great visual. And there was one where the camera panned back and then you could just see a couple go up. Gosh, man, that was nicely done. The other thing was just him playing the piano. I noticed he was really banging on that piano and stuff. And I liked that they kept that when, even when the water rose, he was still trying to do that. There's just little things like that I love to see. It's like the continuity, like in a movie, right? That kind of thing. I like how they kept that. I mean, even if it wasn't exactly in the tempo that was be playing on the piano, it was just such a good visual because he's playing it fast and then goes underwater, he's still doing it. And actually, you know, I'm thinking about it. Right at the beginning of the video, do you know how he was all wet? I'm probably going off on something here that's not right, so probably shouldn't even say this. But you know, at the beginning of the video, he was all wet and there was still a little bit of water like on the ground. So it's like, I think that's what it was. Actually, you guys will let me know. You guys probably know this. I feel like he came out of that. I think that's what that is, because he was all wet. Because when he was playing, he was dry, I'm almost sure. But right at the beginning, he was kind of like almost sitting there, almost kind of spent. And then he was soaked. I think the beginning of the video is the end. I don't know. I got to rewatch it to make sure, because I might be misspeaking on that. Anyway, if anybody knows that, can you let me know down in the comments below? All right, let me know that. What else I want to talk about? Oh, his shirt. Like, he's wearing this shirt. I don't know if that was that a dress or something, because it was seemed like it was long in the back. It reminded me of the Vogue cover that just came out, or the photo shoot that just came out. One of the benefits of being so late to the party is that I get to see what happened in the world and then watch this and see if there's any cues or anything that came from what happened after this. And for our benefit, yeah, so at the time of shooting this, so I'm right here at the beginning of December 2020, is I just saw the Vogue shoot that came out, and it had that same kind of feel. And you guys know me, I don't get into the nonsense stuff, really, the arguments and all that stuff, like on Twitter. My Twitter is a place for, I want it to be a safe place. I want everybody to have a good time. That doesn't mean if you come at me personally, it doesn't mean I'm not going to defend myself. Of course. I mean, that's just human nature. I'll be honest, I've probably only responded to a couple things that I felt were a little nasty, but for the most part, I just ignore it and I just move on my day. Most of the time, to be honest with you, I don't even see it, because some days I'll scroll through and there'll be hundreds of notifications or tweets or something, and I can't even see them. Even people that I really truly care about, just so you know, sometimes I don't even, a week later when I'm like in the car, if somebody's driving me or something, like I will say, oh my gosh, I missed a tweet from this person or that person, and I feel like crap, because I want you to know how special you are to me. That's a whole long rant. The point I'm making is I'm aware of what's going on in the world. I read a ton and I see like kind of what's trending or whatever. And I saw some people, you know, talking about the stuff he was wearing on there. Look, a lot of people asked me about it. I got DMs about it. I got tweets about it. People on my Instagram DM were asking, hey, what do you think about what he wore? Do you have an opinion on all this stuff? I really don't have an opinion in terms of good or bad. Here's what I'm going to say. And that for everybody wondering, since you guys know I'm such a big Harry fan, I have so many, the majority of my content is Harry Styles related. The majority of stuff on my Twitter is Harry Styles related, just because I just dig the dude. I love the dude's music. I like the way that he carries himself. I like treat people with kindness. I'm into it all. So what I'm going to say is, whatever you want to do in the world, as long as you're not hurting another soul, I think you should do whatever makes you happy. That's what I truly believe. That's where I am. That's what I think. And that goes for the whole scope of it. It doesn't mean just for one side either, okay? Because I'm not on that train either. Here's what I'm saying is, if somebody wants to be whatever makes them happy, you can, whatever you want, girl, boy, non-binary, whatever. My thing is this, as long as you're happy and you're not hurting somebody else, there's nothing wrong with it. It's the same thing with clothing. If a girl feels better and she wants to wear like big sweaters or wear a tank top like a dude, like a basketball jersey, whatever it is, if that's where they feel comfortable, that's what they should do. If a man wants to wear something like he's wearing in that video and he feels comfortable doing it and it makes him happy, who are we to sit there and say, oh, it looks bad, or you shouldn't be wearing that because men don't wear it? That's ridiculous. You should wear whatever you want to wear. You should do that. And at the same time, I'm also too, if a man wants to dress masculine and he wants to be a manly man, grow a beard. I'm just jealous because I can't grow a beard. Like literally could not grow a beard. It would take me 5 months to grow like a couple pieces of stubble. But if he wants to wear a beard, chop wood or whatever it is, and I'm not making fun of that, you should do that. If that's how you want to carry yourself, you should do it. You should do whatever makes you happy, as long as you're not hurting anybody else. That's where I come out. It's not one-sided. It shouldn't be just because somebody wants to wear, if a man wants to wear a dress, we should, yes, that is so awesome. But no, you can't dress away. Nah, I'm not on that train. You should do whatever makes you happy. Just don't hurt other people and don't make fun of other people that don't do something the way that you do it. That's how I feel about it. And the last thing I'll say is, it's like with these mother sunglasses, right? I said it before, if you're watching this, and I'm going to say this on one of the Pomoy videos too, because I'm getting a lot of grief about my glasses. Let me end it with saying this. These things make me feel a little more comfortable talking to you guys into a camera. When I play shows, if I'm touring, if I do like a meet and greet or something like that, I don't wear the sunglasses. I have no problem with my eyes. It's looking into this camera that I don't really prefer with my naked eyes or even my regular specs, right? It's just a preference thing. It's a comfort thing for me. I think it's a little anxiety because I don't like to look right into the camera, like right into that barrel. I just don't really like to do it because I feel like my eyes are not focused on where they should be. It is a personal preference. If these make me happy, they make me more comfortable, that's not your problem. Don't worry about it. And here's what I'll say is, since it's free will, you can do whatever you like. If I'm wearing these and they make you uncomfortable, then you shouldn't watch. That's the thing. That's the beauty of it. If you don't like it, you shouldn't watch. But I'm going to continue to wear them. They will be on my videos. I'm having a t-shirt coming out with this face with these sunglasses. And it's going to say Cool Shades. Thank you very much, Chappa. It's going to say Cool Shades on it. You know why? Because I like them. And I'm not hurting anybody by doing them. Right? See that full circle moment? All right, guys, I'm about to get out of here. I want to thank you so much. This has been such a great ride. I think I am caught up on every single Harry Styles music video. I think this is it. If there's another one, let me know. I'm talking about music video wise. I wonder if I should rank all the videos. Because, you know, you live in that moment, that box of, no, this is probably my favorite. Maybe I'll watch all the videos again. Who knows? Maybe I'll share that with you. All right, I'm gone. Thank you so much. This is Tommy Mars. Stay golden.